Thenicenurse Cares with Nurse Esther, popularly known as the Nurse in Pink. We'll be taking the continuation of osteoarthritis, the nursing care plan of osteoarthritis. Before we begin, let us take a quick review or overview of what osteoarthritis is. Osteoarthritis is a chronic joint disorder. It affects the joints, especially the weight-bearing joints of the body, the hip joint and the knee joint. Osteoarthritis can also affect the interphalangeal joints or the joints of the fingers. Osteoarthritis is also called degenerative arthritis. It affects both sexes, but the incidence is higher in women, especially over the age of 55. What are the predisposing factors? Obesity, aging. Degenerative is associated with aging, joint trauma, poor posture, and occupational strain. Now, a quick advice to you, my professional colleagues: try to maintain anatomical posture while carrying out your procedures. You know, most of our procedures requires bending, lifting, pushing, pulling, and even standing, prolonged standing. Try to be conscious of your position at all times. Maintain an anatomical position, that is, keep your back straight at all times. You know, we mentioned that one of the predisposing factors for degenerative arthritis is occupational strain. Be conscious of your position at all times as you carry out your nursing procedure so that you will not be predisposed to degenerative arthritis. The primary cause of osteoarthritis is aging. There are secondary causes also, but the primary cause is aging or degeneration of the joint. Secondary cause could be due to endocrine disorders or metabolic disorders. Now let us take the pathophysiology of osteoarthritis. As a person ages, the elasticity of the joints, the cartilage, and the ligaments around the joints are reduced. The cartilage gives the joint its buoyancy, is soft and elastic. So as a person ages, the cartilage becomes thin and worn out. Just take, for example, you have a chewing gum, draw it to the end, and you see that it becomes thin and break. That is how the cartilage is when it undergoes degeneration. It becomes thinned out and breaks. The bone is exposed, and the function of the joint as a shock absorber is reduced. Because there is loss of stability, this joint space narrows, and osteophytes start to form. Osteophytes are bone growths or tiny bone spores. They start to form. They are indication of inflammation or injury to a joint. Synovial membrane becomes thick and the joint stiffens. And you know, this will impair the movement of the joint because the synovial fluid is a kind of lubricates the joint. When you have a machine and you pour oil in that machine, the friction will reduce. That is the function of the synovial fluid and the synovial membrane. But when it becomes sticky, there is friction and impaired movement of the joint. The joint cartilage degenerates, atrophies, just as I said earlier, degeneration. The joint cartilage degenerates, they atrophy, the articular surface and the ligaments becomes hard or calcified. Osteophytes or bone spores or growths breaks off and becomes loose in the joint, causing more pain and impaired movement. When there is cold, there's muscle tension, and this causes chilling and pain, but there's no muscle swelling. That is the review of the pathophysiology of osteoarthritis. Now, let us go to the nursing care plan. Our first diagnosis, as I said earlier, was in my first video. Please check that out. Now we are taking the second diagnosis. Remember, in our pathophysiology, we said degeneration, formation of osteophytes, and stiffness of the joints. These conditions can cause chronic pain, as discussed in my first video. Now we are taking impaired physical mobility, and that is the second nursing diagnosis. Let us take it properly. Impaired physical mobility related to musculoskeletal impairment and pain. And this is evidenced by limitations of range of movement by the joints. The patient refuses to move, or if the patient attempts to move, there is pain. What are your nursing interventions or nursing actions? Encourage the patient. When there is impairment in physical mobility, as you encourage your patient, assist the patient in performing passive range of motion exercise, passive leg and hand exercise on the bed. Assist the patient and encourage the patient to do it. The scientific rationale is that exercise will help to maintain muscle tone and prevent further deformities. Your second nursing action is that you ensure patient maintains anatomical position while resting or sleeping. That is, should align the spine. You can use a pillow in between her knees when she's resting or sleeping. The scientific rationale is to prevent deformity and to even reduce pain. Your third nursing action, ensure that patient is posture conscious when carrying out daily activities. Prevent deformity. Apply moist heat compress. That is our fourth nursing action. Moist heat compress increase circulation and reduce pain and discomfort. Alternate periods of activities and period of rest. When the patient is resting, allow the patient to rest. When it's time for activity, carry out all your activity at once so that the patient can have time to rest. This will help to prevent strain on the particular muscle and joint. When there's too much activities, you are putting more strain on the joint. So alternate periods of activity and period of rest. Support the patient during period of exercise using protective technique. When you provide encouragement to the patient, you boost his ego and morale. Encourage the patient on the use of assistive devices like crutches, braces, crane walkers, and others. This reduces weight-bearing stress on the knees and increase stability. Prepare the patient for surgery. That is the eighth nursing action. The scientific rationale is that surgery facilitates joint function and mobility, can even retard the disease progression. Evaluation. Patients maintain increased mobility within the period of hospitalization as evidenced by absence of contractures. Please do not forget to give me a like or a thumbs up so that this video can get to others. Thank you. See you in my next video.